The coral seas of Sulawesi support more than 400 different corals and at least 2,000 species of fish. It's hardly surprising that this rich treasure trove has long attracted the attention of local people. The people who built these houses have been fishing here for many generations. Their ancestors were empire-building seafarers. When they beached their canoes on the black sands of Sulawesi, they decided to settle to cultivate the fertile volcanic soils and harvest the riches of the sea. The lifestyle has changed little for these people. Their canoes and houses are still made from the rainforest trees. This wood, along with the vines and flexible bamboo, allows the houses to sway and bend when the sea gets rough. The crude goggles are a more recent addition to the fishing gear. So is the spear gun, which, unlike the ancient spears, is powered by a rubber thong. Traditional methods never did much harm, but this is being changed by modern equipment. The spear gun is more effective than a throwing spear, and it's already noticeable here how few fish there are. Even worse are modern practices such as fish bombing, which can inflict severe damage on the entire reef. The local villagers waste nothing, not even this unappetizing porcupine fish. They have now banned fish bombing on their reef. And perhaps even more surprising is the fact that they spend hours searching when they could paddle their boats a few meters to where the reef is still teeming with fish. This section of reef is protected. Surprisingly, the fishermen are the guardians of this rich area, allowing fish a chance to breed and return life to the rest of the reef.